So of course the DNA barcoding project was planned to just identify the species across the world. But since then, what they've been able to use it for is things like food safety. They've also been able to use it to trace endangered animals. There's overfishing happening down the coast of South America, and they've been able to show that those fish are being sold as regular fish, fish we would normally eat, but in fact are endangered fish. If we're looking at the gorillas over here, they've been able to do things like trace bushmeat coming in from Africa into America that was actually gorilla meat when it was actually labeled as something else. So those are some of the applications.
It can be used to prevent purchasing bushmeat and the incorrect representation of fish. We've done research personally with that and discovered how the barcode can be used to identify the proper fish that you're buying.
What are some of the biggest threats to fish species today?
Well, I think the biggest one is habitat destruction, and that kind of has many forms. So the biggest one is urbanization, and that's a global issue. Associated with urbanization, there's pollution, there's also dam building and barriers, and those can be problematic for migratory species. One thing that consumers can do is be informed, and I brought this with me actually. This is a seafood watch guide. It's a pocket guide. And there's also an app for smartphones for it as well. And it gives a list of sustainable fish, and it shows the ones that you should avoid and the ones that are kind of in between. A lot of fish, when you see a fillet, they're all pretty similar looking in a lot of cases, not all cases, but in a lot. For example, we have here at the zoo a species called ngege, and they're from East Africa, and they're an endangered species, so we wouldn't want that to be confused with another type of tilapia that maybe isn't endangered. So the barcoding could definitely come into play in situations like that.